Welcome to part two of our Freecoaster tech series. In this video, we'll show you how to adjust the slack, re-grease, and maintain most clutch-based Freecoasters, along with discussing the possible issues you might experience after heavy use. Tools needed are a rubber mallet or some type of hammer, an adjustable wrench, 6mm Allen wrench, and some type of grease. We recommend finish line or fill wood. The first step is to remove your axle nuts. Next, remove the drive side cone nut and washer. Many axles are keyed for an Allen wrench to simplify this step. At this point, you can unscrew the driver from the hub. You might have to pull on the driver during the step, as some drivers can be difficult to remove at first. The next step is to remove the axle assembly through the non-drive side. Using your rubber mallet, knock the axle out through the non-drive side. Remove the axle and the clutch. If you don't have a rubber mallet, you can use a regular ball peen hammer and an old axle nut to remove the axle without damaging the threads. Thread the nut on the axle 3/4 of the way down, then hit the axle out. Now remove the non-drive bearing cone. This space here determines the amount of slack. Adding washers will reduce the amount of slack, while removing washers will increase the amount of slack. Remove the non-drive bearing and make your adjustment. On this colony hub, we will be adding a washer to decrease the amount of slack. Be sure to grease the slack washers when installing to prevent binding. Reinstall your non-drive bearing. With a new hub, you can now start to reassemble. On an older hub or one that has been ridden, now is a good time to re-grease the internals. Start by removing any old grease from the axle, clutch, and driver assembly. It doesn't have to be spotless, just a good wipe down should be good. Once clean, go ahead and apply a liberal amount of new grease to the ball spring assembly on the axle. These ball springs are what provide resistance to the clutch and need a good amount of grease to function properly. Now install the hat spacer, making sure to add grease to the axle where the spacer rides. Next comes your slack washers, the non-drive side hub shell bearing, and the cone nut. Make sure the cone nut is snugged up tight. Now add grease to the inside of the clutch, on the clutch splines, and on the threads. Once greased, install the clutch over the ball spring assembly until it butts up to the hat washer. Go ahead and apply grease to the driver threads and set it aside for now. Next is to reinstall the clutch and axle assembly inside the hub shell. Thread the driver in while pushing up on the axle assembly to get everything started and properly lined in place. Now hammer the axle back into place until the hub shell bearing is fully seated. Make sure the driver is fully threaded in before reinstalling the tapered cone spacer. The tapered end should be facing the driver to contact the inner bearing race. Reinstall the drive side cone nut with the knurled end facing out. Double check the non-drive side cone nut, making sure it's tight. Then tighten the drive side cone nut. Finally, reinstall the axle nuts and check for proper function. While the internals on most clutch-based Freecoasters are very similar, some hubs, like this Colt Match, require an extra step for proper function. The Colt Match Freecoaster uses a tapered roller bearing behind the driver for additional side load support. Along with the steps previously shown, this bearing will also need to be re-greased during maintenance. With the driver removed, pop out this tapered roller bearing and remove any old grease. Once clean, start by applying a fair amount of grease between each of the rollers, pushing the grease down and into the rollers as you go. Do this on both sides of the bearing. Now apply grease to the top of the rollers. Insert bearing back into the hub shell and reinstall the rubber seal, making sure it pops back into place. Now reinstall driver just as before. Over time, or after heavy use, you might notice some clutch slip or the hub not wanting to freecoast backwards. This clutch, for example, has had a deep groove worn in from improper maintenance. The rider was not only experiencing crank slip, but the spring balls were catching inside this groove, not allowing the hub to freecoast. If you are experiencing any of these issues, examine the inside of the clutch for excessive wear. Inspect the spring balls on the axle as well. The spring balls on this axle are extremely worn down and flattened, and do not provide the resistance needed on the clutch. A worn clutch or ball spring mechanism will have little to no resistance. For proper function, the spring ball should provide a good amount of resistance against the clutch, yet still able to move back and forth freely without sticking. While there's no set maintenance schedule, we do recommend that you clean, re-grease, and inspect your hub from time to time. Properly maintained, today's Freecoaster has proved to be very reliable and should last you many years to come. Thanks for watching. Please like, subscribe, and stay tuned for more videos on the way.